Joining us now, Benedict Hazan, who co-founded a small business, and Azmat Mohammed from the Institute of Recruiters. Very good morning to you both. Benedict, could you be working harder?
Well, the people we represent are typically young graduates who come to us looking to bridge the skills gap, and by doing so, they'll do an internship, which will normally start on lunch and travel expenses. So, from our point of view, we can see young people coming into our office and being prepared to actually go and work initially on expenses-only internships, which to me says they're working very hard, they're prepared to work very hard. The main issue is there enough companies for them to go into and go and actually learn the skills they need?
Azmat, Defence Secretary Philip Hammond also weighing in an interview on Five Live yesterday, saying large businesses are sitting on a pretty large pile of cash. Got to persuade businesses to take the plunge, just use some of their cash pile and take a judgment about where demand is going.
Well, this is quite interesting because if you think about it, the FTSE 100 companies, the average pay for a chief exec is £3.65 million. Now, we know with the shareholder revolt that these people are certainly being looked at whether or not their salaries are in line with the performance they're driving in their companies. They're also sat on around £150 billion worth of cash. So they've got the funds to be innovative. They've got the salaries to work hard. And I would certainly say if this was directed at those individuals, not your average person who's working very hard anyway, I think they would find it very insulting for somebody to say, look, go and work harder. I say this should be directed at the people who are running big business. They've got access to that cash. And they're the ones who are supposed to innovate for those companies and create the shareholder wealth. Are they doing that? I don't think so.
Well, Benedict, I mean, you were saying you put interns into companies like that. Does it frustrate you that they're not creating more opportunities?
Yeah, but I also think there could be more to do, more to help basically with the infrastructure to help companies grow. So, for instance, I've been saying for a long time, internet speeds in the UK need to be improved. A lot of our clients are tech companies. We ourselves, inspiring interns, we upload lots of videos or video CVs of our candidates, which means we need really fast internet speeds to be able to do that.
And we're not even a tech company. And who's responsible for that, do you think?
Well, either private businesses are given the ability to invest into infrastructure and to benefit from it, or the government has to do it. But at the moment, our internet speeds aren't up to what we need to be. So that's one example of how the government can basically help.
A lot of companies not worry as much about growth as survival these days, though, aren't they?
I think they do. And again, it comes back to being innovative. You've got a company here where they started in the recession. They're now employing 24 people. So there's examples out there that even in this climate, you can innovate. And I think the government's saying, look, that's the situation. We're following our austerity programme. This is what you have to work with. You have to go off and try and make this work for yourselves.
All right, we have to leave it there. Benedict and Azmat, thanks very much indeed for joining us.